Hi, this is Richard from Rich Media Design Productions, and I'm back to show you a little bit more about the animation feature in Photoshop CS5, and in particular, get into a little bit of the other features that it has. And I don't know if you're familiar or not with the filter tool of the Liquify, but it has some fun things that you could do. So I think we're going to make this a fun animation using this picture of a woman here, which by the way was generated by a computer with, I guess, scientific algorithms to give you the perfect face. And by making a morph, you're gonna have to change it in some way. So we're gonna use this new to some, that is, Liquify feature in the filter section, or the filter menu section of Photoshop CS5. Here on the left hand side we have a blow tool and a pucker tool. Those are the two tools that we'll be using today for this particular animation. I thought we might make an alien out of this woman. We'll kind of reverse all the things that these scientists did to make this woman's face. So let's have fun with it. Okay, so I already prescribed the size of the brush for you. Excuse me. And if you wanted to change the size of the brush, it's on the right hand side here. If you notice, it says brush size and it's at 91. At the bottom here, you'll notice that these things are ghosted, and we'll have these light up and ready for use once we start using the brush tool. Basically, I could tell you that reconstruct takes you back, you know, your steps. In other words, if you make some changes, it'll allow you to do deconstruct in increments. So to say reconstruct, I would say deconstruct, because actually the original is the original construction. And then restore all, right next to it on the right hand side, is actually just restoring it all at one time. Okay, so let's go on with this, and I'm going to start. If you remember the aliens from Area 51 and all these alien sightings, they have big eyes. So let's start with that. We'll start enlarging. Using my mouse, I'm going to click until her eyes get enlarged. I centered the crosshairs right on the pupil. So that looks pretty good. Actually, that left side looks a little bit bigger, so I'll give that one a little bit more here. That looks about right. And I guess one more click and we got it. Yeah. Okay, now I'm going to go on the left-hand side of the tools and click the pucker tool. And then I'm going to pucker her nose. Remember, the aliens have little tiny noses. So I'm clicking, and it's down to size. Now I can also move it by going back to the bloat tool and sort of get that that other one look better. So let's get it back down. Okay, now we want to do the mouth too, so let's get that mouth size down. That looks like a pretty good alien there. Go back to blow tool. Let's get her head.
Another feature that I wasn't really planning on, because actually I didn't think about it until now. So here is a paint tool that's called the color replacement tool. And basically what it does, and it replaces colors. Okay, it actually takes a color that you have on your palette, and if you look over in the left, there's the green already there. It'll use that color and replace the colors that you want it to. So in this case, it'd be the skin color. I'll leave the eyes alone and the hair, and we'll just go in there and paint the skin of this woman's face, or alien's face now, and see how it looks. Okay, so let's do that. I'll start right here and just come in here and left her eyebrows brown, right? So that's
okay.
Close.
So if we go up to the window and select animation, that's window down here on the list, you'll see animation, and you go ahead and select that, and you'll see an animation bar appear. Now, what this bar tells you is that there's a timeline here. In other words, this is the time it's going to, or the frames that indicate the or the area where the frames will appear and show you how these transitions on this animation bar are going to take place. Right now we have a frame on the timeline, and that's the face of the lady on top here. Now, if I wanted to add a frame, all I need to do is go to this area here, press it, that's duplicate frame, and now you see that I'll have a duplicate of both of them. Now, this basically will tell me that I can't make an animation if both frames are going to be the same. So what's going to happen here? We're going to add a feature called tweening, and it's going to tween between the first frame and the last frame, and we're going to put some in-between frames that will actually cause the transition. So in order to make this frame the last frame, I go ahead and deselect the girl or the woman, and you'll see that now the alien is the last frame. So now I'll shift, press the shift key, select both of them, and that will allow me to affect both frames, and go over here to the tweening feature and press that. That tells me that I can now add some frames in between these two. This tells me that I'm going to add 12 frames. I'm going to go ahead and select this because that's exactly what I need, and it's going to affect the frames in between and add 12 frames. So here we see all frames are selected. Now, I'm looking at the bottom here, and all of them say 3 seconds. Now, that's a long time for the transition to occur. We want this to kind of be slow, but not that slow. I mean, it's going to take 3 seconds to go from one frame to the other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this frame here and press my shift key and select this next key, and I'm going to put no delay on here, meaning that there's not going to be any time in between the transition, so it's going to go pretty fast. Okay, I'm going to go to the first frame, and I'm going to put about 2 seconds on there instead of 3 seconds. And this last one seems to be okay at 3 seconds. Now, do we make her go from normal person to alien and then back again? That might be a good idea. Okay, that sounds good. So let's go to the beginning. Now press this over here to start at the beginning. And then I'll press play and move this out of the way because it's going to show up on your screen in the wide or the larger picture. So let's let her rip. And it'll go forever unless I stop it, or we have a power outage. That's going to be it for today, and I hope you come back for another one. I think we'll do something interesting. I haven't really thought about what it will be, but if you have any suggestions about anything that you'd like to see done, just give me a holler. Just leave me a note, and I'll take a look at it and see if we can do it, okay? Thank you again, and we'll see you next time.